the top 10?
These are in no particular order. We completely randomized them. They're not by contestant number. They're not by highest or lowest score in the top 10. They are completely 100% random.
Your first contestant in the top 10 is contestant number 29, Morgan.
Your second contestant in the top 10 is contestant number 37, Aria B. Cassidy.
The third contestant is contestant number 38, Giselle Cassidy Carter.
Your fourth person in the top 10 is contestant number 43, Tatiana Boucher.
The fifth contestant joining us in the top 10 is contestant number 19, Barbara Seville.
Next is somebody that we had originally given an award to last night that actually didn't get it, and so I hope she'll be happy with this. She's actually in the top 10. Contestant number 17, Chloe Knox. Yeah!
The next contestant joining us is 16, Giselle Monet. Yeah!
Number 8 going into the top 10 is contestant number 31, Tijuana Ross.
The 9th contestant joining us up front is contestant number 10, Janae Starr.
And your final contestant in the top 10 is contestant number 18, Desi Love. Yeah! You know, every year it gets harder and harder to get in this top 10, so, I mean, these girls did phenomenal.
Come on, Barbara!
All right, thank you. We're gonna dismiss the top 10 and let you get ready for presentation. Thank you, ladies. Congratulations. I forgot what I had to do there for a moment. I was just gonna let them stand around. And let's give a big round of applause to the ladies standing on stage. Everybody here worked so hard. There's a lot of time, effort, and money put into this. They all deserve this love. Thank you, we'll see you later on tonight.
welcome to the stage of the sign and presentation. This is our first contestant, first final tonight, but our contestant number 10, Janae Starr. Let's hear it.
Janae Starr is a vision in green, a metaphor for her journey to Miss Gay America. Miss Gay Arizona America, Janae Starr presents the illusion of the prickly pear goddess. The prickly pear cactus is known for its resiliency in the harshest of climates and its ability to flourish no matter its environment. Once again, contestant number 10, Janae Starr.
Contestant number 16, Giselle Monet.
Giselle's presentation is an ode to 1990s, 2000s punk glam fashion. As a 90s kid and 2000s teen, she's always been drawn to the fashion of this eclectic era. She chose to take the era of her childhood and the color purple that represents her late great grandmother and aunt to present an edgy twist of her aesthetic. Once again, Giselle Monet, contestant number 16.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage this time. This is contestant number 17 in presentation. This is Chloe Knox. Let's hear it.
Contestant number 17, Chloe Knox. Although there's no bio, you can see how fashion-forward she always is.
Chloe Knox came all the way from Dallas, Texas. She shows red because red is edgy. She is a fashion girl. Red plaid is resemble of the fashion house called Alexander McQueen. And I believe she made this whole gown herself. Give it up for the fashionista, the iconic Miss Chloe Knox, contestant number 17.
Please, welcome to the Shakespeare presentation this time. This is contestant number 18, Desi Love Blake. Let's get it.
Positivity and optimism, which are all traits needed as a Miss Gay America. She presents to us a bright yellow, high fashion look with a subtle hat, which is her favorite style of drag. She is best known for bringing over-the-top costuming, a little hat, and a unique fashion sense to the stage. So this look is a great representation of her brand as Desi Love Blake. Once again, give it up for contestant number 18.
Next contestant, please welcome contestant number 19, Barbara Seville.
Barbara Seville pays tribute to the power of dreams and the ultimate dreamer, Don Quixote. Don Quixote, the man of La Mancha, dared to dream the impossible dream. Quixote looked at the world for what it could be, seeing the possibilities for a just, fair, an ideal way of life, to dream the impossible dream, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable star. Once again, Arizona's own contestant number 19, Barbara Seville.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage in presentation competition. This is contestant number 29, Morgan. Let's hear it!
When asked what color she would like to select, Morgan immediately chose the color red, representative of the nurse's cross. As a registered nurse, her fiery passion to provide protection and care for patients drives her to be a better version of herself every day. Morgan's initial look defines and defies society's expectation of perfection, the perception of being flawless and not having defects. Morgan emanates being true to herself by transforming from what the traditional norm to reveal something that makes her her. By raising awareness of society's expectation of people to portray perfection, hopefully more of us will feel confident in shedding the pressure to be unflawed and showcase our true selves. Our imperfections may in fact be our most beautiful gifts. Never let anyone define you. Let your flag fly. Define yourself and realize that being your authentic self is the best medicine. Once again, Morgan, contestant number 29.
Yes. Please bring to the stage contestant number 31, Tijuana Ross.
Tijuana Ross, Arkansas, she is Tijuana Ross. The color that she dreams in is blue. She chose to design a look influenced by an adventurous, strong, female space explorer. As a first-time Miss Gay America's Nationals contender, she wants to test the theory, the sky is the limit. Once again, contestant number 31, Tijuana Ross.
In presentation, this is contestant number 37, Aria B. Cassadine. Let's hear it.
For her presentation, she presents to you the illusions of all illusions, the showgirl of all showgirls, Dolores Van Cartier. Aria B. Cassadine is back in the habit at Miss Gay America. Once again, give it up for contestant number 37, Aria B. Cassadine.
Our next contestant.
Contestant number 38, Giselle Cassidy Carter.
To Giselle, when she dreams in color, she envisions all the beautiful yellow flowers planted in the Earth's garden. Yellow flowers have many meanings, some being happiness, optimism, loyalty, and positivity. Plants with vibrant yellow flowers are some of the most beautiful in the garden. From large, tall sunflowers to pretty yellow buttercups or huge gold-colored chrysanthemums, there is a type of yellow flower to suit any taste. Once again, give it up for contestant number 38, Giselle Cassidy Carter.
Now to the last contestant. Please welcome contestant number 43, Tatiana Beauchesne.
Your last contestant in the top 10. Please welcome to the stage contestant number 43, Tatiana Beauchesne. Tatiana brings a stunning vision in the shade in all shades purple. As Miss Gay DC America, she displays a custom presentation of great purpose and meaning. Purple is often associated and aligned with royalty, ambition, creativity, wisdom, pride, and of course, magic. Purple Rain continues in this inspired masterpiece that has been custom designed for this very important moment tonight. This purple ribbon takes shape to highlight the main reason Tatiana chose the color purple, as it supports her future platform as Miss Gay America, which spotlights anti-bullying in our LGBTQ youth. Purple puts us in touch with the part of ourselves that is regal, vibrant, and strong. As a national symbol of excellence, Miss Beauchesne is passionate about conveying to the LGBTQ plus youth that there truly is strength in numbers. Yeah. Purple is the queen in all of us. It helps us keep our backs strong with our heads held high with confidence and purpose. Floating from top of the feathers to the bottom of this custom encrusted rhinestone dress, Purple Rain is Tatiana Beauchesne, who is ready to share her vision for a better future for all and reign with excellence.
We're gonna start with the first contestant, contestant number 10. Please welcome Janae Starr.
So the red light means we're ready. Let's do this.
Most days I don't recognize me. these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be. Oh, it's true, I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tried. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. It's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for the girl.
So said yes sir and yes sir and no sir. When it comes to the part, I said no significant role.
Do you hear what I hear?
No, Seth, I'm serious. Do you hear what I hear?
It's like a ringing. What the hell is that? It's killing me. I haven't heard ringing like that since the big blackout of 78.
I remember that. You know, New York City lost power for like 27
years. No, Seth, my blackout. Yeah, I was dancing at Studio 54, passed out, woke up 2 weeks later in Thailand. Terrible ringing in the ear.
All right, let's get back to the actual acts. We kind of got a little bit off track
Seth,
there.
I am so excited that I'm going to be performing in front of a live audience again. You know, my father always said I was a whore for applause. But I added the four applause part.
Hey, let's focus on the accent.
I didn't even think I was going to be able to make it here today with the taping, but then the new liver took. Yeah, didn't think I was going to get one, but then this young mother died in a car crash or something. Important thing is I can drink like a fish again. But not that I need to. No, I just drink to be social and keep from shaking.
Okay, that's not really bad. So let's actually say the word you're going to say. Here we go, the actual material. Oh,
fine, fine. Wine?
Christmas is all about love.
Christmas is all about love. Thank you, Seth. The love a man feels for a woman, or one of your kind feels for another one of your kind. And I know I'll never love this way again. And go right to that Lionel Richie number.
All night long?
No, just once, because I gotta get out of here. You know, everybody loves Christmas, but my favorite part is the parties. We're gonna party, caramba, fiesta, whatever.
We've got three measures.
I can't remember.
We've done three measures of each song. Let's actually do a song that you know, start to finish.
What are you
all
saying?
The lyrics, all the patterns.
I know.
You don't know
songs.
Anything. I did
these
songs. I did these karaoke versions. I plunked out your
I know these songs.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Sing out yourself some of our little Christmas.
I will. Now, this was Judy's number. But I think you're all going to be pretty pleased when you see what I do with it. Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Thank you. This is a talent competition contestant, number 18, the one and only Desi.